SwiftUI offers many different ways of styling text in your apps, but sometimes you don't want to style your entire text view, but only parts of it. So let me give you an example. Usually, if you want to color your entire Hello World text here, you would add a dot foreground style of, let's say, red, and then your entire text would be red. And next you could, for example, also make it bold. This is great if you want to change the appearance of your entire string. Now, in SwiftUI, there are also different ways to only change the appearance of parts of the string, and let me show you two of them. So the first one would be that we remove the second part of the string. So let me cut that out, then add a plus sign and add a second text with this second part of the string. Now this plus sign allows me to concatenate these two text views into one view. And as you can see, they're not vertically ordered. And in fact, we're not inside of a VStack here. And even if we were, they wouldn't be vertically ordered. But instead, they are actually considered as one text view. And this, of course, now gives us the capability to only style part of the text. So we could now apply this foreground style to only the hello text, and then only that first part would become red. And the same also works for font weight modifiers like dot bold. This does not work for modifiers like dot padding, because dot padding doesn't return a text. Dot padding returns a view, and this is a major difference here. So you can only use modifiers that are defined on text as well as on view, but not the modifiers that are only defined on view. So this is an important point here, and foreground style and bold are both available to return a text type. So either we use this plus sign, or let me cut back out this entire text here and remove this foreground style here as well. Another option is to use string interpolation. So I think we don't want this space here. So instead, let's have it like that. And then you can see we have a text inside of an interpolation here inside of another text. So this might look weird in the beginning. And for an example of just two plain strings, this really doesn't make sense to use this. But now this allows us to change the second part here, for example. Now, of course, we could have the hello text inside of the world text, but I think you get the point here. So this is just the other way around. And now we can concatenate view modifiers to this text view here. So now we can change the foreground style to orange of comma world exclamation mark, and then you can see that turns orange. And once again, here we can use all of the modifiers that are available to return a text instead of just a view. And this is a bit confusing here in the autocomplete, because this does say that the modifier returns a view, but bold, for example, also does work. And if we go back to foreground style, you can see that this one actually returns text. And we might even be able to command click into our foreground style API here, and then you can see it does in fact return text. And if we scroll down, font also returns text, font weight also returns text, as well as font width. And here we also have that bold view modifier. And in fact, this isn't a view modifier, this is a function on the text type.